ask for direction?
Yes.
Well...
Miss Galloway?
I don't want to interrupt your reading.
Realistic, I like very much to have you read, so he likes to write the reading. I prefer to talk.
Well, if you insist, you know you have a big science girl I was in, and I had my eye on your science yesterday.
Yesterday?
Didn't know somebody was bold over those spray lamps. Did you honeysuckle?
Honeysuckle? Oh, you must remember that I'm late. I always feel very much you have to be because your mistake was doubtless an unnatural one in your circle. I asked you to sit down. If the mistake was not true, your honeysuckle, consider it is young.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to offend to you. I just remember I mean there are girls in parks, you know.
Abandon the subject, please. Of course I know.
Right.
Now, tell me about these people who have been passing each way, in all of these parks, where are they going? Where could they hurry from? Are they happy?
Yes, it is interesting watching them, isn't it? The wonderful drama of life. And some are going to supper and other places. One can help but wonder what their histories are.
Yes, how fascinating they seem to me. Especially about with their pretty little dreams and common worries. I am curious to sit because here, only can I be near the great, common, human heart of humanity. My part of life is past, which never its feeling is never felt. Can you tell me why I spoke to you, Mr.
Parkinsacker, and your name?
No, you would recognize it immediately. It's simply impossible to keep one's name out of the papers or even one's portrait. And this will and this hat and my razor course are my only protection. They furnish me with an inkcloak. The chauffeur is waiting. The chauffeur, you staring when he thought that I did not see. Candidly, there are five or six names that belong to the Holy of Holies. And mine is, by the accident of birth, is one of them. I spoke to you, Mr. Stackenpot.
Mr. Parkinsacker.
Mr. Parkinsacker, because I wanted to talk, for once with a natural man, with a real man, one unspoiled by the despicable gloss of wealth and supposed social superiority. You have no idea how weary I am of it. Money, 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 and of the men who surround me, dancing like little marionettes, all cut from the same patterns. And I am sick of pleasure, of jewels, of travel, of luxuries, of all kinds.
I had the idea that the money must be pre-creating.
A competence is to be desired, certainly. But when you have so many millions that it is the monotony of the black holes, drives, dinners, balls, and followed, of course, by more dinners and more balls, and over it all. Sometimes the very tinkle of the eyes in my champagne glass nearly drives me mad.
You know, I always read up the customs and habits of the wealthy class, and I think myself a bit a professor on the subject, and I like to have my information accurate, and I had informed them about the champagne is cooled in the bottle, and not by saying, but placing isn't cool in the glass.
You must understand that we of the non-useful class depend for our amusement upon departure from the precedent. Just know it's a fact to put ice in champagne. The idea was originated by the Prince of Tartary while dining at the Waldorf. It will soon give way to some other whim.
I see.
These special diversions of the inner circle do not become familiar to the common public, of course.
It's so fascinating, and I always represent on or eat the least first witness and the elite.
We're drawn to that which we do not understand.
That's right.
For my part, I've always thought that if I should ever love a man, it would be one of low station. And one who is a worker and not a drone. But doubtless claims of taste and the wealth will prove stronger than my inclination. I am visited by two searchers. One is Grand Duke of German principality. I think he has or has had a wife from somewhere, driven mad and intemperance by intemperance and cruelty. And the other man is English Marquis, so called, and emotionally, that I even prefer the diabolical nature of the Grand Duke. And what is it that impels me to tell you these things, Mr. Stackenford?
Oh, Mr. Partystacker.
Oh, of course.
I don't know why you should bear your soul to common men like me. I can't know how much I appreciate your confidence.
What is your line of business, if you don't mind asking?
A humble one. I hope rise in the world one day.
You have aspirations?
Yes, and what did mean before it? When you say it to yourself,
And I admire your enthusiasm. I myself can find very little enthused about, burdened as I am, constantly pleasures and diversions of my class.
Oh, but you have said there are so cold.
Yeah,
and you love a man in a low station.
Indeed I did, but I said might.
Wait, just only might.
Well, there's a Grand Duke and English Marquis to think of, you know.
And didn't really?
Now, I'm sure you understand when I say there are certain expectations of a young lady in my position. But it would be such a disappointment to certain members of my family if I had married to a commoner, as we like to call them, it would be the scandal it would cause. All the magazines remark after me.
I work in a restaurant.
Not as a waiter?
No.
Waiter is not.
No, I'm cashier. In this restaurant over there.
That one? That one there?
Yes.
Are you sure?
Yes, quite sure.
I'm late for an important engagement.
An engagement?
Yes, it's an engagement.
But will I call? And some sort of ball?
Yes, yes.
Will I see you again?
I do not know. Perhaps the wind may not seize me again.
And a red running gear.
Yes, but I always come in that. Pierre is waiting here. But good night.
Wait.
Mayday! Parker! What news are you doing here? Don't you know what time is it? To whom are you speaking, madame? To whom am I? To you! Who do you think, honey? Then I'm sure I know what you're talking about. Your ship started 15 minutes ago. Mr. Winterswood is in the lane. So sometimes, once you have been late, you had better get closer earlier. And before you go, you put your boots for boots. I know you can afford to mistake. Katie! I'm sorry, you have been confused with me, someone else.
Confused with? Why, Mary Jane Parker? We know each other for 3 years. We swap ship. Have you been drinking?
I'm sorry, Mr. Parker, whatever.
Mr. Partystacker.
Mr. Partystacker?
Yes.
As in the society page? Society page?
If only I were one.
You must excuse me, my shepherd is waiting.
Gemma, what kind of crazy air are you putting on? You have never shepherd in your life.
I do so.
Since when?
Since? Oh, get away from me, I don't know you.
Don't tell me! You have been eating! I'm going to your mother!
Wait, your partner, sir.
We need your partner, sir.
Yes, Henry.
I don't mean to intrude. What's your dinner reservation? Shall I ask for?
No, I'm coming.
Very good, sir. The auto is waiting.